Hello, this is the aftermarket report with Vegas and Jim. Today's date is February the 7th, 2019, and what a great day again today it was. And I'm going to hand this right over to Miss Vegas.
Well, good evening, everyone. And, you know, the markets have been a little bit all over the place, and it really is about, you know, looking for good setups and good ideas that can still keep you hopefully making some money. And the ones I'm going to talk about today, you guys know if you listen to the YouTube, one of my favorites is SHRMP, S-H-M-P. That is just phenomenal. I'll talk about that shortly. We're going to talk about CRON. We're going to talk about Mattel, the toy company. And then I'm going to give you guys a bonus. So you have to listen in order to get that bonus. And then I'm also going to talk about Sears, SHLDQ. So let's start with natural shrimp, SHMP. Now, I've been talking about this for several weeks, and you know, you guys know that this company, they're called Natural Shrimp. They're in Dallas, Texas. And what they do is they definitely try to grow fresh shrimp in an indoor environment. And, you know, they're trying to grow it in, obviously, in salt water, an environment that can be replicated anywhere in the world. So by doing that, they would help also fish farmers who suffer from, you know, diseases that are out there in the water, and, you know, due to storms or coastal zones. This product they have is really going to help. And, you know, this company has been nothing but money. I mean, these shrimps have become jumbo shrimp. I mean, I remember we talked about this in one of our videos. I wish I could find the exact date, but I have it here that it was mentioned at 01057. And you know what? We mentioned it again not too long ago at 0.056. And do you know that this went to 42 cents? So you want to talk about making some serious money? This has been a phenomenal, phenomenal payday. For those of you that have been even scalping it, you are making money. I mean, even today, people scalp this for a good 10 cents. So I'm going to turn it over to Jim because he's been loving shrimp as well. And these shrimps have become jumbo shrimp. So, Jim, over to you to talk about that chart.
Well, we had a 42-cent high today on shrimp. And this is a yearly chart, so we're way past the resistance levels, which was way down here around 13 cents. So I'm going to pull up the 20-day chart right now and talk about shrimp. This is where we called it at, right down here around 127, somewhere in that little area. Probably right around in here is where I started looking at it. And she's bounced on up. She's had a wonderful run, a real positive run with very few pullbacks. And we have for the last, 3 days, 4 days, we've had some little consolidation pullback, and then it bounces right up. And this is a 20-day chart. So I'm going to pull it down to a 1 day. I'm going to talk about the channel that I was talking about in the room today. We've got some newbies in the room that's never traded before, so they're learning off my charts and learning off Vegas's fundamentals, and she also is a good chartist herself. So we've kind of having us a little breakout today. From the very beginning of the day, we noticed it was jumping on up, and it ran all the way from this level here at 25, which I called a pullback in the last time we mentioned it. Support level was right around this 24, 23 area. And started bouncing up into the hours after yesterday. And yesterday was not a good day in the market. As everybody noticed, everything was pulling back. And I was yelling out, get your pencil and paper out and start writing some stocks down for today's watch list. Well, I noticed right out of the gate, shrimp started to break out. It pulled back right to a support level right around 28.89. Created a little channel here. That's where I started drawing this channel. These two lines right here, and this other is a little pivot point. that I was calling maybe if it pulls back or it bounces up to, it could be a support resistance level. And so now I'm going to pull it up and magnify it now. We had, at the end of the day, once we hit that 42 high, she started pulling back a little bit. So I was calling the supports off the 200 SMA. Let me magnify this up a little bit. All these blue lines are my trend lines where I find supports and resistances. And I was calling this 37 cents out. And right there is where it come close to hitting that 200 SMA, kind of consolidated. Bounced up to the 4094 area, which is around 41 cents. And then she pulled right back again. I called it out again. I said it's another entry level to get in the stock. And it did pull back a little bit under that 200. So I hope it didn't scare anybody. But I did say it was getting ready to break out because we had a little hammer here. And she went ahead and she bounced up and hit that 4094 again. So this was a little resistance line all day long, this 4994 after the breakout to 42. And then she pulled back and then she bounced up and hit that again. And then she kind of pulled back to that support level that I called out earlier in the day at 37. And that's what these trend lines are real good for, is coming back and falling back into them channels. You see, I could put another circle right here, which I will, so I can remember it tomorrow. And that's going to be a little support area for tomorrow in case it wants to pull back. And I'm pretty sure if it does pull back, we're going to see this 37 for a support area. And then what we want to do tomorrow, if it keeps on wanting to run up, or it might consolidate because it is a Friday. It is a Friday. So if it runs up to this 42 and double test this resistance level, we'd like to see it break out at a double top. And that shrimp, we're definitely 100% bullish on this stock. I'm keeping it on my watch list every day, and it's one of the first ones I look at. And the next one we're going to talk about is another one of my favorites, and that's CRON. Miss Vegas, do you have anything you'd like to talk about CRON about?
No, you might as well just go right into it on CRON, because, you know, you guys know that that's one of Jim's favorites. I love it as well. Had a beautiful run, had a nice pullback today, and Jim's just going to talk about CRON and the action that's on it and where it's headed to next, because, you know, you've got to take advantage sometimes of these pullbacks, and I think today was a good opportunity. But I'll turn it over to you, Jim.
All right. Well, as everybody knows, I've been 100% bullish on this stock ever since it was down there around $7, and I had a target to 10. And then pulled back from that 10. And once it hit that 10, again, I had a target to $20. So I want everybody to remember that $20 level. Now, the thing that gets me about CRON is we've got people wanting to short this thing. So every day it's been popping this news out that it's overextended. It's over, been downgraded because it's up over 100%. Well, particularly, it doesn't hurt me one bit because I'm 100% bullish on it. As you see the pun, they think it hit 100% gain and they're going to try to short this stock. Well, anybody that's trying to short this stock is making a big mistake. And sometimes the media can interfere with your own thoughts, so just kind of cut it out. But we did pull back. You know, the sentiment everybody's talking about, it's going to pull back, it's going to pull back, it's going to pull back. And when you get so much of that, you know, and they have used that article again in here today, trying to remind everybody, and they're going to probably do it again tomorrow because there's people that are heavily invested to short this stock. Well, I'm solid support on this stock at $20, and it did pull back today at 1860. I guess it kind of, people were trying to take advantage of that, and I understand. If you have a little patience on it, let them do their thing. The thing's going to bounce right back up. And I've called pullbacks on this stock all the way from when it was at $10 every trading day. I said, don't chase it. Let it pull back and get in it. So anybody that's been listening to me talk about CRON, that's been my statement. So this morning, when it hit that 1860 level, it started breaking up again. And then it hit that around $19. I took my eye off of it. And I started watching shrimp and a couple other stocks. And when I got back in here, I said, oh, man, look at this. Within a half hour or so, it ran all the way up to 2140. So at that time, I drew me a little wedge downward pattern on this thing. and I followed that wedge, and I got into it right around here, right around the $20 support level, which I've called out in the room many a times. That was my old resistance, which now became my good new solid support. And it hit off that 20, 2010 to be exact, and went down to about $20. And then it bounced on up, and Vegas was going to make she was going to buy a put or a call on this when it was up here at this level, and I said, let's be patient with it and let it pull back. And it did pull back to that $20 level, and then we tried to retrace that top that it had previously, but it just couldn't do it. So we started playing it off the 200 SMA, as you see right here. The 200 SMA come down to touch twice. And this is a very good on breakout stocks. These are my three moving averages, the 50, the 100, and the 200 SMA. So she went ahead and she retraced and broke above this 2140 and went up to after hours here to around Vegas's call. She did alert the stock saying it was going to go to 2150. It hit 2148. And we pulled back a little bit after hours. So when you come in the morning, I want you to not chase it. I don't think you need to chase it. I think it will pull back a little bit. If it does, it's going to be in this little channel that I called the other day, which is at 2031 to 2055. And if them don't hold, wait for that 2010 area. And that's basically CRON. And try not to fall for the negative sentiment on this. They're going to probably come back out with that article again, say it's been downgraded. But I don't think they know, they understand this stock or they understand the sector that it's playing in. And that is CRON. And the next one we're going to talk about is one that Vegas mentioned. It's popping up after hours. And that is Miss Vegas.
Yeah, so this one is MAT, which is Mattel. So, you know, they had earnings today after hours. And I have to say they beat Wall Street estimates. And I keep explaining this to you guys, you know, if a company beats earnings, but it does not beat Wall Street estimates, the stock doesn't really move. It has to beat Wall Street estimates in order for the stock to move. So that's interesting because sometimes, you know, company does really well and we're like, how come the stock's not moving? They beat earnings. And it's like, well, they didn't beat estimates from Wall Street. So in this case, Mattel beat Wall Street estimates. And the reason they did is that the Barbie doll and Hot Wheels has made them an amazing amount of money. But specifically with Barbie, I just want to mention that it's been the highest gross sales in 5 years. What the company's done to actually generate additional revenue of 12% on Barbie was because they actually launched the Barbie dolls with different skin tones. They added plus size dolls. They added ones with hijab wearing models. And, you know, they also added like new science kits to actually make the dolls more educational. And you know what? That was a really good strategy because the sales went up 12%, which is great. The only thing, though, is that, you know, Toys R Us used to be a major retailer that used to sell a lot of the Mattel products. And unfortunately, because Toys R Us is bankrupt, you know, they don't have the you know, retailer to actually use the dolls and products for the Mattel brand. So they probably would have had a lot more revenue if they had another outlet to showcase the products. But anyhow, they've done extremely well. And the net income was $14.9 million, which is great, which was compared to a loss of $281.3 million last year. So that's actually great. And, you know, Mattel's been really good at cutting at least $650 million in costs. And that's their plan for 2019, unfortunately through job cuts, but other options by looking for other manufacturing facilities. So I'm going to turn it over to Jim because I'm really impressed with the run that it's had after hours. I mean, almost $2 a share from the open today at 12:39. So, wow, what a run. And you know what? Congratulations if anyone's had this actual stock or was playing it on an earnings play. Great, great return there. So good job.
All right. Well, this is Mattel's one-year daily chart. You see the moving averages were moving down. Been snugging around this 50-day here for last month or so. And this is one of them plays that if didn't do well during the Christmas season, as you can tell, but neither did the market. The market had that real bad December, which is probably the, one of the worst ones in the year. Well, she had her little double bottom here come to the first couple of days of the year. And then from then on, like I was telling everybody, play these bottom plays because we're going to have a very good January. And so she ran up. She was down here at 926, little support area. And let me change this thing here so I can draw that trend line. Right there at 929, 926. And she's ran up and hit that resistance level at 1272 and kind of pulled back. So then here right before after hours when it popped, we had another little pullback to that 50 SMA. And I'm going to magnify that up a little bit. You can see what I'm talking. We had the double bottom. She ran up, hit resistance. You can tell by it was pretty close to resistance here at around 1285, but it fell short. She pulled back and created a support here at 1179 and then bounced up and tried to hit that resistance again, pulled back to that support, and here we are. So let me pull up the daily 1 minute. Here's the pop after hours. It kind of dipped down first to 12 bucks. Once it did that, she ran all the way up to 1477, come down and touched my 50 SMA here after hours. So that's kind of after a good pop like that, $2.80, it's going to consolidate and pull back. So I'm really excited to see what this is going to do tomorrow. Like I said, tomorrow is a Friday, so it might consolidate a little bit. And let me look at the 20-day chart, see if that tells us where those resistance lines that we're going to be looking for. We have this. Let me see here. Let me pull up one more little chart here on the yearly. Kind of get a little idea. Pull up 3 month. Well, that was a 3 year. 3 month daily. There we go. Now we can see what I'm talking about. So we're right now we're at 1410. I'm going to show you the tape on it. Still a lot of big buys coming in at 1410. And that's right around this 1415 area right in here. So we've got different resistances. You can stop this recording and write these numbers down. 1415, then we've got the next one's going to be 1450, 1482, and 1527. But we could pull this thing back. And I'm going to do that by pulling up this daily now. Actually, I'm going to look at one more thing here. It's kind of hard to see both of them. I'm thinking the good solid support on this is going to be around 1381 to 1334, somewhere in this channel right in here. And if it really wants to pull back at resistance, that would be right here at 1273. But I don't know if it's going to do that or not. So I'll pull up the daily. And we have a little support level right here around 1395. And I have another one at 1381, 1336. So I think best thing to do is just watch this tomorrow and try to find you a foundation of support and see if you can pop and scalp it or maybe hold it long for the rest of the year. But me, I'm going to just watch it tomorrow and see if I can find me a nice little entry to scalp it myself. And that is MAT. What a great pop after hours. Let's pay good attention to it and they might come down and touch these moving averages, which is my 200. My 100 and my 50. And if it hugs the 50 and runs up above it, that means it's still solid. If it goes down below that 50, try to catch it at the next support level. And that would be the 100 or any of those trend lines that I have on this chart. And that is Mattel. And I do like this company. And Vegas, the next one's going to be our bonus play.
Yeah, so the next one, this is an OTC stock. And I want to mention on here, it's called Alernet Systems. The ticker is ALYI. And this company here is really good. I mean, this company, from what I see here, they are focused on what they call environmentally friendly energy storage. including consumer electric vehicle and military applications. And they have a lithium battery powered motorcycles, which will be followed by motorbikes. And they are releasing these products through their launched Revolt electric motorbike subsidiary. Now, this company is in Dallas, and they also mentioned that they did an interim report, Jim can show you there in the news, on a test pilot of their electric motorcycle in conjunction with a $1 million fleet order from Nairobi, Kenya. Okay, that's an interesting place that's ordering this, which is their shared ride client. So what they're going to be doing is their pilot test is expected to bode well for two additional pilot tests, triggering an additional $500,000 in orders. So they expect to get sign off on this pilot test actually today and announce the triggering 1.5 million order on Friday. So you know what? I don't even know. We might even see another PR tomorrow saying that the deal's been signed and that they have an order for $1.5 million. They also have a new hemp energy storage initiative, which is confirming that their hemp energy storage project, which was headed by the professor from Clarkson University, David Mitlin, and he's an expert in electrochemistry, and he's also a pioneer in the use of hemp as a clean energy renewal in the form of a supercapacitor. Anyhow, so this will be quite interesting. Currently, he does also hold, this is very important, a U.S. patent for his proprietary hemp energy storage technology. So the fact that they have him on board and that he's their expert helping them with this is actually amazing. I mean, imagine using marijuana as an energy tool. That's just incredible. So the other thing I want to mention, not only this news and give you a little brief on the company, but the money that is flowing into the stock. You know, it's very important if you got if you actually at the money that's flowing into this actual stock. And one of the things that I was looking at with Patrick, who helps me out with the night school for the OTC stocks, is that there's over $2 million a day flowing into the stock money-wise. And that is a lot of capital coming into the actual stock for an OTC stock. That's a lot of money. So, you know, on that note alone, there's a huge interest. This had a nice run. This could be a future, maybe something like a shrimp kind of a move. I can't say for sure, but definitely it's something if you're not in the stock, you should definitely keep this on watch. I mean, the analysts have said this maybe could go to 9 cents, could go more, could go less. Nobody knows for sure, but definitely the volume's there. The money's coming in. The technology's great. And I see this for a continuation tomorrow. I let Jim talk about this chart. But this is really important. And they also had news earlier this week that they did have, listen to this, they planned to pursue research investment with an electric vehicle battery market to reach $93 billion by 2026. So they feel that the market is there for the hemp energy storage solution. So this company, to me, looks like it's definitely going to be worth more as the demand for what they do is going to become more popular. Again, do your own due diligence, but definitely one to keep a watch on. And so far, I'm really liking this very much. Jim, over to you.
Yeah, they even mentioned the word Tesla in one of their clippings there. So they might.
Oh, they did. Yep. Wow.
They might be charging up some of them cars with this battery charging stations.
So that's cool.
ALYI, yearly resistance on this chart, and we touched that a couple of times the other day. It was right around 3.1%. I mean, excuse me, 3 cents, a little above 3 cents. And she pulled back right around to 2 cents right here at a support level. And she bounced off that yesterday and run up a little bit and then pulled back down. But today was the day of the big breakout when the news came out about that $1.5 million order coming, you know, by Friday. And so I was watching the tape all day on this thing, and it was just beautiful. I jumped in it when Vegas mentioned it, and then I got scalped it. I still have a small core position I'm presently holding. But if it dips down tomorrow a little bit, I'm going to get back in it. But it does have a 9 cent price target on it. And I want to just show you about how beautiful this chart looked today. I mean, after that initial breakout yesterday from 2 cents, it ran all the way up to that resistance level of three cents. And then this morning, it just took off like a little bitty rocket. Come back and found a little support level here at 3.3 and followed that 50 SMA all the way up. You had one chance to get it in it down here at the 100, but it's held strong all day long. And like I said, man, this thing's up here. It had a 6.95 high. I think we'll maybe see 9 tomorrow. The tape on this thing was just beautiful. Vegas and I were talking about some buy and sell orders that came in on this today, and it was just amazing, you know, how big the orders were, 200,000-300,000 shares at a time. And, you know, I bought a piddly 20,000 shares and kept 20,000 shares. But it still was a pretty little penny to put it in my wallet. So I'm going to be scalping this like I scalped shrimp and like I scalped BCCI and just like I scalp all these little penny stocks. But actually, I'm telling you, if this thing kicks off, this is way undervalued right now. And it was way undervalued yesterday at 2 cents. So here we are up 300%, almost 350% from that yesterday's low. This is ALYI. You definitely want to keep this bonus play on your watch list. Don't chase it. See if you can, who knows, if the tape's running good, you can probably scalp it for a good 2 or 3 cents tomorrow very easily and maybe hold a position over the weekend. But and I want to thank Patrick for educating Vegas about the money flow on this stock. That's a big bonus. When you have like $2 million coming in on it on a daily basis, that means people are interested in this play. ALYI. Don't forget it. And the next one, this company's been around for what?
Yeah, hundreds of years.
Hundreds of years for a long time. And it ended up with having a Q on it.
Okay, so this is our good friends at Sears, SHLDQ. I mean, this is a sad story, you guys. You know, we talked about this, how the bankruptcy, but you know what? Some good news here. So, I mean, it opened today at 0.575. Went as high as 0.79. You know what? This is up 32% today. But I do want to mention the news on this. You guys know that the chairman of Sears, Mr. Lampert, Edward Lampert, he was wanting to actually, you know, take over Sears, and it had to go to a bankruptcy court. And there was news on this after hours that the bankruptcy judge has approved that the chairman of Sears, Edward Lampert, that for $5.2 billion, he can take over Sears. This will allow the department store to avert liquidation and preserve tens of thousands of jobs. We're talking about 45,000 jobs. The judge, which was Robert Drain, he approved the sale after hearing about this in his bankruptcy court. He overruled the objections from the unsecured creditors committee, which included vendors and landlords. And, you know, they felt that the company would be better if they liquidated it and that this was very unfair. But you know what? It doesn't matter what they think. It matters at the fact what the judge, and he approved this takeover. Now, what's going to happen is that this gentleman here, Edward Lampert, he has a hedge fund called ESL Investments. And so he's going to keep it alive through his hedge fund. I think this will be quite interesting to watch tomorrow. Don't have a position in the stock whatsoever, but I'm definitely going to be watching this because I think this is good news. You know, I mean, it's still sad what's going on with Sears, but I think the fact that it's preserving 45,000 jobs, you know, I feel for those people. I mean, imagine after all these years, you lose your job. I mean, you know, maybe they can get some sort of like unemployment, but you know, it's never the same. Some of those people will never work again. They've been so loyal. They've been there forever. It's their first job. You know, they've been at Sears for so long, and it's tough. You know, when you get to a certain age in life, it's not easy to find a job. And you know what? I think it's actually good that the judge approved this to help those people that hopefully will not lose their job. I still think there will be some losses in the jobs for sure. But you know what? 45,000 jobs, that's a lot of people.
Yep.
And so I think it's great. I think it's nice that the chairman wanted to take over this. And maybe there's a plan to turn this around and hopefully prevent it from being gone for good. So remains to be seen. It'll definitely be on watch because this news came out after hours. And so, Jim, what are your thoughts on what you're seeing here with this chart and your thoughts on this news?
Well, you know, I shop at Sears, and it's good to keep these brick and mortar stores going. I think just the internet kind of spoiled that with buying your stuff on the internet. But I always like going shopping. You know, I go to Sears and I look at their clothing all the time. And the fact that they're going to preserve 40,000 jobs, 45,000 jobs, and keep 425 stores open, I think it's a great idea. I mean, I think he'll make his money back. We're at a bottom here. Let's pull up the chart. Let me look at a year. I always like to look at that year first. Kind of gives me an idea of where we're going, where we're coming from. We had a high, year high up here at 408, and she's been on a downward path. We mentioned this stock when it was getting down here around 12 cents, 15 cents. Said it might be a good idea to grab you some and hold on to it. Well, here we sit now at a double top resistance here at 75. And I'm going to open it up to a day, to a 20-day. You see what I'm talking about? We're starting to big up some momentum here for the last couple of months. And this thing was very, 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 very cheap. So we had a breakout the other day on it. It ran up to the resistance level of right around 79.84. And I don't count the wicks. I count the bases as a resistance level. And then I draw another trend line right here, and we broke out of that a few times. So I'm going to go ahead and put this 77.23 here. And that's why we got a breakout tomorrow, somewhere around that 77.25 area. If she pulls back any, she can pull back to the 70 cents and be very happy with that 70 cent level. Maybe a little bit lower, right around 68, 61. And then you got another little support level right here, and I'm going to bring her, well, we can put one there at 64 and maybe another one here at 66. So what I want to see, I want to see this double top breakout here at 79.84 and continue on up. And I'm going to pull up the yearly chart or a monthly chart. And you can see my next resistances. If we re-break that double top, we can take it up to 84.20. Once it hits that, 84 cents, then we got the next resistances that move on up. And if you want to pause this chart and draw these support levels down, I feel free to do it. I don't mind if you share them. So the next one we got here is 98.28, 117.74, 131. I mean, after this deal with the bankruptcy, I'm pretty sure the Q is going to drop and it's going to bring it back up to a dollar. And that is SHLDQ. Good luck.
All right. Well, I think this wraps up the market report for the I Love Stocks. But I do want to announce and let everyone know that currently we have, you know, in our information section here, the videos, we always post the link to come by and visit the chat room. And we're pleased to announce that we're going to have an I Love Stocks Discord channel. And we will actually be launching it officially on Monday. But we will, and so we'll be able to post the link in the Discord on Sunday. And you're welcome to come check it out. And we have some new enhancements we're going to be adding to the channel. And still the same with the voice. It's still Jim and I talking on voice. We have Leo who's going to help us out with pre-market. And so we're very excited about the channel, and we hope that you will definitely come by and check it out.
and, you know, participate and learn. And if you join, you join. If you don't, like we've said before, no problem. You know, you can still access us through YouTube. As a matter of fact, I've actually had a couple conversations with people from YouTube that sent me an email asking me if I could give them a call about some advice they wanted on some trading strategies. So I had some nice conversations with a couple YouTubers out there. So I'm glad that you're reaching out. And again, we're just here to help the trading community. So stay tuned for that. And Jim, anything to add?
Yeah, I'm just excited about our new channel we're going to have. We have a bunch of good followers that are in the room right now, and they're going to follow us right over to the new channel. We want to give special thanks to Leo that created that channel. He's a wonderful man, a wonderful human being. And Vegas and I have been together for now almost 2 years now, trading together side by side. So we know how to feel each other out when it comes to trading stocks. And I'm just excited to start off here in that new channel. And I'll still be doing the same thing. I'll be teaching on voice. I'll be talking all day on stocks on voice. We'll be setting out alerts. We'll still have, you know, other people in the room giving out options picks. And I am new to options, so that's going to be exciting too. That's going to be what I want to really get down in the year of 2019. And I've been trading for over 15 years. And Vegas been trading for quite a while herself. And I have a lot of respect for the young lady. And she does a very fine job with her fundamentals. And we just are excited to open up this new room. And, you know, there's not much more to say. The stocks we picked out today were all good stocks that we like. Mattel's probably the one that I haven't watched much, but I'm going to keep it on my watch list now. And really keep good eye on our bonus pick. I think this could be another shrimp, like what Miss Vegas said. And that's ALYI. And I really like the tape today on this stock. So that's it. We're going to have, like she said on Monday, we're going to have the new link to our new room. And we're going to get everybody adjusted in the room now to the new room tomorrow. So this is the aftermarket report. Feel free to drop in. And today's date, February the 7th, 2019. And I love stocks.